Hey, what's up, guys? Welcome back to the channel. Just want to let you know that my G Fuel code is once again 30% off. That is code Prestige at checkout. Get 30% off your entire order. Gfuel.com, link in the description below. So a community update came out on the 21st. I know I'm a couple of days late. Oh well, I want to talk about it because there's been some updates to the Trello board as well, adding a little more detail on some of the glitches and bugs and things that have just seemed downright broken that Infinity Ward's looking into and, of course, will be fixed hopefully sometime soon. I say soon, but then again, the Ram 7 Platinum Camo still doesn't work. Okay. Anyway, on to lighter notes, starting on Tuesday with a playlist update, we're going to be getting 3v3 snipers only on Rust. Hopefully that doesn't include marksman rifles. I'd like to see it more bolt action and maybe even just take out the Dragunov altogether. The other thing that we're going to be getting is an infantry ground war playlist. What that means is we are not going to be seeing tanks unless they're called in via a streak. So no more vehicles that actually do destructive bits. We're not going to end up seeing people on the top of the hill on the quarry shooting a tank for endless amounts of hours because it just annoys the shit out of all of us, right? So that's going to be cool. I'm actually interested in seeing how that plays on certain maps like Krovnik Farmland. I really like that map when it's just me versus other players and no tanks involved. It's going to be interesting to see how that also plays with the spawn balance. You can actually push people back into their spawn quite far, and if you don't go DEFCON and cap all the flags, people are basically forced to stay back there. So this could be an interesting way to kind of mix up the game, and maybe you're going to get some easier nukes. Who knows? We'll have to wait and see. It's definitely going to be interesting to see, though, because if someone's not in a tank, I'll usually jump in it and take out Harriers or Chopper Gunners, AC-130s, depending on how far they are, and if I'm able to aim that high. So, yeah, streaks are going to be much more deadly without the tanks, at least I think. But then there's probably going to be more people running launchers. I don't know, man. It's going to be cool to see, though. Tuesday is also going to bring our brand new gunfight map, Bazaar. Like I said in the breakdown video for the Season 2 trailer, I think that Bazaar looks like Ramaza, but a bunch of boxes and a bunch of clutter inside that long hallway. Here's some gameplay clips of Bazaar. I don't really know how well this is going to play. I'll probably jump in a private match, and maybe once in a while, if it pops up in the gunfight tournament mode, that's probably the only time I'm ever going to play it. And just like this weekend, how we had double weapon XP, next weekend is going to bring us regular double XP. So if you wanted to complete those officer ranks faster, get to rank 155 even faster, and basically have nothing left to do for Season 2, then play next weekend. You'll get that double XP and get there in no time. That's all we know so far for next week and the update that's coming on Tuesday for our playlist. No word on whether or not Rust and Shipment are going to be broken up, or if we're going to go back to just Shipment 24/7, or if it's just going to remain the same way it is right now, or if Shoot House is going to be making a return and we're going to have a menage a trois of three maps in one. I guess I could see them doing that, but I don't know. I know a lot of people out there just want Shipment back for challenge reasons, and I don't blame them. Let's go ahead and move on over to the Infinity Ward Trello board, because some stuff has been added this month that I actually haven't seen working incorrectly, but apparently these are bugs. So if you guys have been experiencing these, just know that they're actually working on it actively, and hopefully it will be fixed sometime soon. Many people out there don't know that Infinity Ward have a Trello board, so I'll link it down below in the description. But this is a board where developers put up known issues, issues that are being fixed, issues that have already been fixed, what they're currently working on, and stuff coming in the future. So make sure to check out that link down below, as this can update daily depending on what they plan on doing. So on the left side, you can see that there are multiplayer known issues as we scroll through this. Some of the things that you're going to see in here include the green breadcrumb, or the green notification that pops up in your calling card menu showing that there's something new there, when in reality there really isn't anything new there. This is a bug that they are planning on fixing, and hopefully it will come sooner than later, because yeah, that pisses me off too. Ground war exploits, most likely including out of map glitches, under map glitches, and wall breaches. And unfortunately, if you're one of those players that suffer from the infinite update loop kicking you back to the main menu and saying that there's an update required to play the game, this is still a persisting bug. Activision Assist has told some people, including my brother, that they need to clear the cache on their system in order to stop this from happening. And I guess this has been working for the most part. Activision Assist does have a pinned tweet on their page that actually shows how to clear cache and delete files on both the Xbox, the PS4, or the PC. So I'll put a link down below in the description for that as well, if you're one of those poor, poor souls suffering this infinite restart loop. And the final thing I'd like to say that they're looking into, once again, is player collision. We haven't really had much in regard to communication about player collision. we kind of know that it broke a little bit, then they touched it, and then they tried to fix it, and it broke it a little bit more, then they kind of did fix it, but it didn't really fix it. Player collision is kind of strange, especially when you're trying to snipe or do something that requires you to be stationary. If a teammate runs into you, it can knock you out of place, it can make you miss your shot, or it can put you in the line of danger. So there's lots of issues when it comes to player collision. And, you know, honestly, I kind of wish it was like it was back in the day where you could just run through each other and you wouldn't ever get collision. So maybe that's a little too unrealistic. But then again, we have pink tracers. Pink tracers are a thing. Anyway, guys, let me know what y'all think about it down below in the comment section. No reason to take this video to 10 minutes long. If you guys enjoyed it, drop a like on it. Subscribe for more videos coming very soon. And if you haven't yet, ring the bell icon next to the subscribe button. That way YouTube will notify you every single time my videos go live. I'll catch y'all in the next one. Peace.